Hello dear students, welcome to the last video for the lesson the nervous system. In the last three videos we have learned about the unit of the nervous system, that is the neurons. We have also learned about the parts of the nervous system, reflex action and reflex pathway. We have also learned about the structure and functioning of eyes and ears. But these are only two of the sense organs. We will be learning about the other three sense organs, that is the nose, the tongue and the skin in this video. The nose is the primary organ of smell and functions as an important part of the respiratory system. Besides this, it is also involved in tasting. The air that we breathe in is filtered through the hair that is present in our nostrils. The inhaled air is warmed and humidified before it enters into the lungs. The shape of the nose is due to bones and cartilages. The nasal septum is a partition which separates the nostrils and divides nasal cavity into two. The bridge of the nose is made up of bone. The rest of the sides of the nose, the height and width of the nose, as well as the shape of the nose is due to cartilage. The hollow space through which air flows into the nose is called as the nasal cavity. A septum or a thin wall made up of bone and cartilage divides the inside of the nose into two chambers. The nose as well as the throat is lined by a mucous membrane. The mucous membrane moistens and warms the air we breathe in. It also forms a sticky mucus that prevents dust and other small particles into the nose. When you suffer from a cold, these membranes are even more stimulated and they start producing excess of mucus to get rid of the foreign particles and the germs. This is why you have a runny nose. The main functions of the nose are to help in inhalation, to purify the inhaled air because of the hair that is present in the nostrils, which trap the dust particles and prevent them from entering into the nasal passage. The hair, the nasal hair also moisturizes and warms the air so that it resembles the air temperature and moisture within the lungs. The nose also acts as the organ of smell. The inhaled air comes in contact with the smell receptors at the top of the nose and the nerve fibers extending from them send the signals to the brain. The brain decodes these signals so that the smell is identified. You must also have noticed that the sense of smell is closely associated with the sense of taste. While chewing, the food releases certain chemicals that travel up the nose and activates the smell receptors inside the nose. They work in coordination with the taste buds of our tongue to identify the actual flavor of the food. When you suffer from a cold or a runny nose, because of the overproduction of mucus, the smell receptors are blocked. This prevents you from smelling the food that you eat, and hence you lose your appetite when you suffer from a cold. Let us learn how we can take care of our nose. When your nose is dirty, you tend to pick your nose. This kind of a habit can cause damage to the inner lining of the nose, which can not only cause pain but also can cause infections. If your nose is dirty, you should use a clean cloth to blow your nose and clean it in this manner. Always inhale as well as exhale through your nose. This is because your nose has hair which filter off any dust or dirt or germs could enter the lungs. always breathe in and out through the nose, even when you sleep. This is because, as we have learned, our nostrils are lined by nasal hair, which acts as a very effective filter. We do not have these kinds of filters in our throat, and hence we should always breathe in and out through our nose. Now let us learn more about our tongue. The tongue is a muscular organ in the mouth, covered with a moist pink tissue. It is involved in several functions, such as licking, tasting, helping in chewing the food by moving it around the mouth, breathing, swallowing, and speaking. As you must have noticed, your tongue is not smooth but is covered with small bumps. These bumps are called as the papillae. The papillae present on the tongue gives us its rough texture. The papillae are covered by a number of taste buds. Approximately 2000 to 10,000 taste buds cover the surfaces of individual papillae. There are several nerves in the tongue that help in transmitting taste signals to the brain and thus helps in the taste sensation. The human tongue is capable of sensing four different tastes: the bitter taste, the sour taste, the salty taste, and the sweet taste. As you can see from this diagram, the taste buds for these tastes are concentrated in different regions of the tongue. Let us learn how we can take care of the tongue. As we have learned, the taste buds are present on the papillae and they allow us to sense taste. Hence, it is important to keep the tongue clean by using a tongue cleaner every day. Gargling and removing any dust or any layers of food on the tongue is also important. Always avoid foods that are extremely hot or extremely cold, as these can cause damage to your taste buds and prevent you from tasting the foods temporarily. Now let us learn about our largest sense organ, that is the skin. The skin is the body's largest and heaviest organ. Its most obvious job is to protect our insides from the outside. But there is more to the skin than just that. Alongside its role as a protective barrier, the skin helps us to maintain the right internal temperature that allows us to sense the world through nerve endings. The skin's sense of touch is what gives our brain a wealth of information about our surroundings, about our environment, temperature, humidity, and air pressure. And most importantly, the sense of touch lets us feel physical pain. It is a necessity to feel pain to avoid injury, disease, and danger. Skin has three layers. The outermost layer is a waterproof barrier that gives the skin its tone. Interestingly, it's mostly made up of dead cells. The dead cells are shed or removed continuously from this layer, and new cells which are formed in the deeper layers will move towards the outermost layer and replace them. We shed around 500 million skin cells each day. New cells are made in the lower. The color of our skin is produced by a pigment called as melanin. Melanin is produced by cells found in the outermost layer of the skin. These cells are called as melanocytes. The melanin pigment protects the skin from the harmful UV rays of the sun. Our sense of touch is controlled by a huge network of nerve endings and touch receptors in the skin. This system is responsible for all the sensations we feel: cold, hot, smooth, rough, pressure, tickle, itch, pain, vibrations, and more. Within the system, there are primarily four main types of receptors which help us perceive pressure, vibrations, and texture, temperatures of object that is hot or cold, pain that is caused by mechanical stimuli like a cut or a scrape, thermal stimuli such as a burn, or chemical stimuli such as the sting from that of an insect. It also helps us to find the position of the different parts of our body with respect to the other parts of our body. The important task of taking these messages to the brain is taken up by the neurons of the nervous system, which pass the messages in relay till they reach the brain. So how can we take care of our largest sensor? Most obvious way to take care of the skin is by keeping it clean, that is by having regular baths with a mild soap. It's also important to take plenty of water to have a healthy, supple and smooth skin. Good hygiene also plays a key role in good skin health. Wear clean clothes every day. Whenever you step out into the hot sun, protect your skin from the sun's harmful rays by using a good quality sunscreen. Nourish your skin with skin foods such as foods rich in omega-3 fatty acids such as fish, almonds, walnuts, green leafy vegetables and fruits. Now let us recap what we have learned about the sense organs, the nose, the tongue and the skin. What are present at the upper part of the nose? Nerve cells are present at the upper part of the nose. What in the nostrils filter the air entering the body? Hair in the nostrils filter the air entering the body. Then what kind of an organ is the tongue? It is a muscular organ. The human tongue can detect four different tastes, and these are the taste of sweet, salty, bitter and sour. What in the skin can detect different sensations? Nerve endings in the skin can detect different sensations. The pigment that is responsible for skin color is melanin. The five senses. Smell is the one with the best memory. This is a quote by an author, Rebecca McClanahan. This is because the sense of smell is known to instantly transport us to the time when we experienced it. Therefore, different smells are closely associated with different emotions and different memory. I will see you soon again. Until then, goodbye and keep learning.